Hey Table Tennis Junkies, this week's video is an introduction on how to serve legally in table tennis. It's mostly meant for beginners who are just starting out or for players who kind of want a refresher on what you're allowed to do and what you're not allowed to do on your serves. If you know somebody with illegal serves, this might be a good video to share with them. I think there are more rules around serving in table tennis than any other part of the sport. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to just go over the big rules. I don't want to go through all of them because there are too many and most of them aren't going to apply in almost any situation. The rules in this video are all excerpts from the ITTF 2020 rulebook. So if you're looking for some really dry reading material, I'll have the link to it in the description. The first rule I'm going to mention is that once the ball has left your hand on the toss, the point has started. So if after you toss the ball in the air, you decide it was a bad toss and you want to catch it, or if you whiff the ball, you would actually lose the point. Rule 262 in the ITTF handbook essentially says you need to throw the ball in the air and not sideways. The exact verbiage of the rule says you need to project the ball near vertical. Whenever you put something subjective into a rule book like near vertical, it leaves room for interpretation and different umpires interpret the rule differently and enforce it differently. There's actually been some talk of changing the rule so that the toss has to be a certain number of degrees off of vertical, but those changes haven't been applied yet. If you're a beginner and you're trying to serve legally, the main thing you want to do is just try to throw the ball up into the air and not sideways into your racket. Most players would consider a serve that is thrown at least 6 inches in the air or 16 centimeters into the air as legal, as long as it's going up more than sideways. This actually leads me to the next rule I want to mention, which is rule 263 in the handbook, where the ball needs to travel at least 6 inches vertically or 16 centimeters, and you have to contact the ball on the descent. Rule 264 in the handbook specifies that you need to throw the ball up from behind the end line and also contact it from behind the end line. You are allowed to throw it from past the sidelines, but it needs to be from behind the end line. It also specifies that you need to throw the ball up from above the surface of the table, so you can't start anywhere below the surface of the table and toss it from there. The ball needs to be visible from the moment it leaves your hand to the moment you contact it. Rule 265 in the handbook specifies that you're not allowed to hide the contact of the ball with your arm or your hand. And this is a relatively new rule in the last 10 years or so. Before this rule was made, players used to turn their bodies and serve from behind their arm and their shoulder. So as a returner, you had really no idea what spin was on it because you couldn't see the opponent's racket and you couldn't see the contact of the ball. So you were really in the dark and you had to rely on like the way that the ball moved in the air. And there were just so many unforced errors and missed serves. And it was a really good thing that ITTF made this rule because it's really helped table tennis. It's made the rallies much longer and the points much better. Next rule I want to mention is that you are allowed to serve to anywhere on the table from anywhere on the table. A lot of beginners think that that you have to serve cross court. That's actually not a rule. In doubles, however, you do need to serve from the right half of your side of the table, cross court into the left half of your opponent's side of the table. Rule number 2911. These rules are getting pretty long, but basically what it says is that if the ball hits the net on the serve, you redo the serve. And there isn't a limit to the number of nets you can serve in a row. And I think I mentioned this in a previous video, but one time at the US Open, I was serving and I served 8 nets in a row. And I kept serving nets and I hated it because I felt like I was giving away all my serves and not really gaining anything from them. But I wasn't losing the point. It was just another let serve and another redo. And I ended up losing that match. If you're just playing guys at the office or friends in the neighborhood, you probably aren't gonna get called on your serves, but most people wanna learn how to do things properly. So hopefully you learned something from this video. Don't forget to subscribe for more free tips and videos. And if you have any questions about serves or anything at all, put them in the comments and I'll get back to you. That's all for this week. And again, there are a lot of rules in table tennis about serves. So if you really want to read them all, I have the link to the ITTF handbook in the description that you can check out. Remember to share this video with somebody that you know who has illegal serves. And thanks again for watching and I'll see you next week.